Good morning students. Now we are going to see the next topic called wireless LAN. In the previous video we have seen the topics on wired LAN. So now we are going to see on wireless LAN. So in this video we are going to discuss in wireless LAN topic, we are going to discuss on wireless Ethernet, which is called as IEEE 802.11 project, and we are also going to discuss on personal wireless LAN, which is called the Bluetooth. Okay, first we will see about the comparison between the wired LAN and wireless LAN. Next we will see the difference between wired LAN and wireless LAN. Coming to the first difference between wired and wireless LAN, the first one is a medium. So here the wires are used to connect between the devices, right? In wireless LAN, coming to this wireless LAN, here the medium is used is air. So through air the signals are broadcasted. Okay, so here the signals will be, that is like whenever two devices wants to communicate, there will be a point to point communication. So there is a point to point communication occurs in case of wired LAN. Coming to wireless LAN, here the broadcast is done. Here the broadcast. Okay, two devices or two or more devices, when they want to communicate, they need to do the broadcast. Okay, and the second difference is that host is usually connected to the network through link layer addressing. So we have link layer addressing, which we have studied in ARP protocol. So host, when they want to connect, host is connected to the network through link layer addressing. Okay, link layer addressing in case of wired LAN. In wireless LAN, host is not physically connected. They are not physically connected to the network. So since we are not going to use any wires, so it is not physically connected to the network. Next, fourth difference is that in wired IOS isolated LAN, what happens is you have a devices like this, and when they want to connect, they can be connected with the help of a switch. Okay, they can have a switch, so which connects all the host. So we can say wired isolated LAN is a set of host connected via a switch. Okay, they are connected via a switch in case of wired LAN. Coming to wireless LAN, so we can call that infrastructure to be an ad hoc network. So if you can see this, we can call this as an ad hoc network. So wireless isolated LAN, is called as ad hoc network, where all these set of hosts can communicate freely with each other. Without the help of wires, they can able to communicate easily. Okay. So the next difference is that connection of wired LAN with internet. So coming to this wired LAN, how we are going to do the connection is via router. So you have so many hosts which is using a switch, and from there we are going to use a router to connect it with the internet, wired internet. Okay. So this is the case in case of wired LAN. Coming to wireless LAN, all the host, this is a wireless LAN, and if they want to communicate with a infrastructure or internet, so they need a router over here. Okay, they need a router, and one more thing which requires is that access point. They need an access point. So the access point, what it does is, it is the one which acts as a glue between two different environment. You can see here there is a wired infrastructure and this is wireless infrastructure. This access point act as a glue between two different environment. So it combines the two different environment, one wired and one wireless. We can also say the communication between this access point and wireless host is wireless medium, and the communication between the access point and this infrastructure or internet, it will be in wired medium. So this is how the connection takes place in case of internet. Okay, these are the differences between wired LAN and wireless LAN. Coming to the first difference, we have medium is the first difference. Here the wires are used to communicate. Here the medium is done. Here it is through air we are going to send the messages. Here point to point communication is used. Here the broadcast is done. Here it is when a host wants to communicate with the network, we use link layer addressing. Here we will it is not physically connected to the network. And the next difference is that we use switch to communicate all the devices. Here it is the infrastructure is it is called as ad hoc network, where all the devices can communicate freely. And the next difference is fifth difference is whenever we want to connect this wired LAN with the internet, we use a router, but here we use it is called an access point which acts as a glue between this wired medium and wireless medium. Okay, next we will see the characteristics of wireless LAN. So wireless LAN is a fast growing technology. So everyone are using mobile devices, like everyone wants to connect with the devices without using wires. So it is rapidly growing technology. We can say that wireless LAN concept is rapidly growing technology. So we will look into what all the characteristics we have in wireless LAN. The first one is attenuation. And we can say these are the problems of wireless LAN. First, coming to attenuation. So when a sender sends signals to the receiver, so here to the destination. So here, since the signals will be sent through broadcast, so what happens is that the receiver can receive multiple signals. So only a small portion of the signal will be received in the destination. Because since the strength of the electromagnetic waves will rapidly degrade, so only a small portion of the message will be received. So since it is done through broadcast, so electromagnetic waves will degrade, and since it is dispersed in several directions, only a small portion of the message will be received in the receiver. So this is the attenuation. The second one is interference. So here we have a source and destination or receiver. Since a receiver, so the receiver may not receive the signals only from the intended sender. It may also receive signals from other senders also. For example, this is sender 1, this is sender 2, sender 3, sender 4. Everyone are using the same frequency band. So the destination will not only receive the signal from sender 1, it may also receive the signals from other senders also, but with those are using with the same frequency band. So what happens in the receiver is there occurs an interference. So this is also one of the problem. And third one is multipath propagation. So here the receiver, so sender and receiver is there. So receiver may receive the same signal in multiple ways. For example, since a sender is sending through broadcast, so they can also reflect it back. So you have in walls or any obstacles nearby, so they get reflected and they get reflected back, and they all these signals will be sent to the receiver. So this receiver will get the same message in multiple path with different phases due to this obstacles or walls. So this is multipath propagation. And the last one is errors. So error and error detection become more serious problem in case of wireless LAN. Because of all this broadcast, error detection and errors, we have to take it seriously and we have to do some error detection mechanism in case of wireless LAN. So what are all the characteristics we have is attenuation. So when since the sender is sending the message to the receiver through broadcast, so the electromagnetic waves, since it is since it disperses in several direction, only small portion of it can reach the destination, interference. So here the receiver may not only receive the signal from the sender, from the intended sender, it can also receive the signal from other senders also, those are using with the same frequency band. So what happens over here is interference occur. And third one is multipath propagation. Since it is dispersed in several direction, all these signals get reflected back from the obstacles or walls, and the same signal can also reach the receiver. So it will receive the same signal in multiple path. The last one is errors. Okay. Next topic we are going to see in this wireless LAN is there is a problem called hidden station problem. What do you mean by hidden station problem is, so suppose for example, you think that there is a station B which is having the transmission range. The transmission range of B is like this. It is shown in oval shape. And transmission range of this C is within this particular range. So this is the range of C and this is the range of B. And you have a station which is in between B and C's transmission range. So any station within this transmission range can able to hear the signals transmitted from the station B. So any station within this particular transmission range can able to hear when C sends any data. So for example, here the B wants to send information to A and C also wants to send information to A. Okay, since C is out of range of B and also B is also out of range of C, so both of them thinks that the medium is free. So when both wants to send at the same time, C sends the data to A and B also sends the data to A. So what happens over here at A is like interference, or it may be interference occurs, or this collision or interference occurs at A. So this is because C thinks that the medium is free, so it uses the medium. And B also thinks that the medium is free, so it also sends the data at the same time. So at A, so collision occurs. So this happens because of hidden station problem. So C is hidden to B and B is hidden to C. This problem is called as hidden station problem.